Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to episode 327 of the Spearhead Sundays podcast. I'm your host, Lewis Spears. Do I look like a supervillain with a cat on my lap and the red lighting? Mr. Bond, you've come here to be entertained for 40 to 50 minutes by a giant man with braces who says problematic things. Is that what it looks like? A little bit. Is this a fit or do I look like fucking ridiculous? The denim shirt and like the.
I think the denim shirt looks cool.
Yeah, but the
jeans being three-quarter jeans, it looks a bit silly.
Well, don't expose me like that, man, because they're not on camera. All right. For all they know, these jeans could be the perfect length. They're not. Look at this. You can see my slutty little ankles. I would get beheaded for this in certain countries. I don't know about the hat, though. I feel like the denim shirt and the hat. You know what I look like? I look like an undercover cop. Is anyone here selling illicit substances? Perhaps I could buy some from you in this car that has the cigarette lighter removed and replaced with something that is not a microphone. I've got autism. I'm on the spectrum. Do you know what I did the other day? I'm on the specky as fuck. And you would think that perhaps amassing a giant audience of people who are absolutely specked up to the gills would be a bit of a hint.
Yeah.
The only thing that really locked it in for me was a few weeks ago, I went to a live music show. Small band. They were great. Can't remember their name. No idea. Doesn't matter. And it really hurt my ears. And I thought, I want to be going to more live events and some more live music, but I don't want to hurt my ears. So I went out and I bought some earplugs. And I have not gone to a social event since, but what I have been doing is wearing them all the fucking time. I've been wearing earplugs all the time. Initially, I was like, oh, I'm just going to buy some. And then when I go out to a live event, I'll wear them there to protect my hearing. I got the minus 50 decibel ones. They're like those, you see ads for them. This is not sponsored. They're those loop earplug things. They were like $50. I just got them and I was like, all right, cool. And then I didn't use them for like weeks, maybe even a month. But then the neighbor started mowing the lawn and it set me off. So I put my earplugs in and my life got so much better. I was like, oh my God, this is awesome. And now, every time I leave the house, I'm wearing them. Every time. I'm just walking around in earplugs. I'm one of those. And it's fucking so sick. You know what used to set me off now that I had? But here's the thing. I feel like it's made me way less tolerant to any sort of noise now. It's like a double-edged sword. Now that I've seen the light, if my fridge starts making noise, I might kill my cat. You know? So now I need the earplugs. I feel like the earplugs have made me more retarded than before I had them. You know? It's like, and that's got me thinking, like, the more that I use the earplugs, the more that I need them. So that's got me thinking, should people with wheelchairs be provided them? Maybe they'd figure it the fuck out if they never had a wheelchair. Have you thought about that? I can't feel my legs. Well, maybe you're just lazy and you have an alternative, you know? It's a lot harder to cook dinner when you've got Uber Eats on your phone. You're like, oh, you know, maybe I'll just let those ingredients rot. Let's get KFC. Gee, that's a real animal move, isn't it? Have you ever ordered like McDonald's or any drive-through food on Uber Eats? You're just scum of the earth. And I'm saying that as someone who's done it quite a bit. Mm. Have you done it?
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
And how disgusting is it?
Yeah.
Because it's not, like, getting pasta from a restaurant, Uber Eats, fucking awesome. That's great because pasta travels well. You get to have like a romantic little Italian dinner with someone, or if you're like in a hotel in a city you don't live in and you're feeling a little bit sad, you get to have three pastas all to yourself, eat them and then feel sick the next day and have it like affect the show in a pretty negative way, but you just kind of play it off. Look, I'm not going to tell you which show it was, but one of the shows in Perth, I had three pastas the night before and the joke suffered. And I won't do that again. But at least I didn't get McDonald's, you know? I went out to get that myself and then almost got fucking robbed because some guy wanted my Nazi necklace. I don't have a Nazi necklace. There's a lot of context missing from that bit. Go and listen to the previous episode. But yeah, dude, getting any drive-through food delivered on Uber Eats, like, you just, it's disgusting. You're not even going to get in your car and do the drive, because the only step you're skipping is the drive-through bit. You know, sometimes you don't want to sit in a restaurant, you know, because after learning a little bit more about yourself, you're like, you know what? I actually hate the downlighting and noise. Pretty soon, the more I start playing into my sensory needs, I'm gonna be leaving the house like you know those fucking horses that do loops around the city. You know, they're wearing blinders so they can only see forwards. They don't get scared by anything. They've got a stupid hat on. They've got earplugs. It's like if they saw anything they weren't expected, they'd just spontaneously kill themselves. That's gonna be me.
Last year, I lived like a block away from a Pizza Hut, and I really like Pizza Hut.
Yeah,
and I used to get it on Uber Eats and Menu Log a lot.
Yeah,
and the delivery driver would always be so frustrated because it would have been quicker for me to walk, pick it up, and walk home.
But isn't that good for him? Isn't it like free money?
Yeah, I just thought it's a waste of time. People, yeah. When I was a delivery driver for Red Rooster, people used to do the same thing. It used to piss me off.
Yeah, so is that when you would drive with a handbrake on? Mm. Or would you save that for the long trips?
I just usually save it for the long trips. Through Frankston and North.
That's awesome. Yeah, because that's the other thing is ordering pizza. You used to do that on the phone. Pizza was the only place that delivered, really. In the whole area, they would have their own dedicated delivery guy, and you would call them on the phone, and they'd deliver it to you, and you'd pay them in cash. And then you know, if they owed you $2.50 in change, they'd give you this look like, are you really going to make me scrounge around my pockets, or am I going to keep it? Like, fuck you, dude. Give me my change. How about that? Give me my $2.50. This isn't the States. I will never, ever in my life tip someone in this country, ever. No way. Keelan does it.
Only delivery drivers.
You're betraying the working class. You're betraying us because the minute that's what they fucking want. Uber Eats wants you to tip because, oh, then we don't have, look, they get tips. We don't have to pay them. No, pay them properly. But also don't, because I like my chippies nice and cheap.
I'm famously anti-worker and I'll only tip if they do a great job.
See, if they do a great job, I'll go, you deserve your wage.
When I was living in Canberra for a little while, we used to order pizza a lot.
Yeah.
And I'd be ordering at like midnight. So I'd be like, don't knock, just leave the pizza out the front and I'll pick it up because we had housemates.
Yeah.
And every fucking time they'd knock.
Because they want that change, man.
You will not be getting a tip from me if you fucking knock.
Here's a tip. Don't fucking knock.
And one time, sorry, last year I ordered.
No, go on.
Pizza Hut.
This is
again.
Good. You know what? If you work minimum wage. Listen up. All right. Turn those fucking ears on, brokey. Go.
And I had the lights on, the address correct in the order. And the guy calls me. He's out in the street going, I don't know which house it is.
Disgusting.
Didn't get a tip.
What an idiot. What a fool. And that's what he gets.
But then last month when I was coming with my friend Michael, actually, back from Brisbane to Gold Coast.
Yeah.
We had a really great Uber driver. And he was making me laugh a lot. So he got a $10 tip.
Oh my God. I'm just remembering my last Uber trip. This is a couple of weeks ago. Oh, this is so funny. Man. I rarely, if ever, talk to my Uber drivers. Everybody knows this about me. I don't speak to you. I sit in the back and I say I'm traveling for business. But every now and then, one of them just fucking gets me and I'll be in the mood to chat. Talking to this guy. And he's super friendly, super lovely. And in the front pocket, he's got, it must have been his daughter's book. He was advertising this book and they had the same last name. So it must have been his daughter's book. So we got to talk about books and stuff like that. And then he goes, oh, so what do you do, mate? And just, again, I never ever say my actual job, but the end of the trip was coming up and I go, comedian. And he goes, oh, comedian, far away, loves it. We start talking about comedy. He really knows his stuff. So I'm like, oh, this guy's cool. And then he goes, so you, are you online, man? Are you big online? I'm like, oh, look, I'm not like famous, but if you Google me, you'll find me. And he goes, oh, cool. What's some stuff that you've done? I went, oh, well, you know, I've done this, I've done that. He goes, what's your biggest stand-up thing that you've done, like that's gone viral? And I tell him about the Prince Philip thing. And I go, oh, I was performing on stage and I've been doing these jokes about Prince Philip for like a month about how he looked like he was going to die and about how, you know, just like a lot of funny stuff about how he's a racist and how, you know, like Prince Andrew's a pedophile and all this kind of stuff. Just like really trashing the royal family because I don't really like him at all. And then the whole tone in the car switched immediately. And he's like, oh, yeah, look, mate, you've kind of touched a nerve there. And I went, oh, really? And he goes, yeah, mate, because I'll tell you what, mate, why don't you Google me? You Google my name and you see what you find. And I Google him. And he was the official photographer for Princess Diana and was it King Charles she was with? Charles and Diana. He was the official photographer for the entire time they were here in Australia. He goes, mate, I was very good friends with the Queen. I knew Princess what? Diana. I knew King Charles. He told me to Google it, his name on eBay. I think Google Princess Diana in Australia photography book on eBay, not on Google. And he'll come up. And I looked it up and his full book. Have you got it up?
I'm just looking it up now.
I'll bring it up now. It was so, and then the rest of the trip, and it was a long trip. It was so fucking awkward. He was very upset. Princess Diana. Australia.
Jim Graham? Oh.
What's the cover of the book?
Is it this one?
That's him, yeah. If you search, it's Princess Diana's on the cover in a yellow dress and he like was their friend for months and months and months and he goes, mate, I know the king. I was actually quite close with Prince Philip. And I just went on this slight little tirade about how he's a racist and I'm like, and the craziest thing happened, he died in the middle of it and then we just started celebrating. Talking about his mate.
That's so good.
Well, he must have been a very good friend because he was fucking driving Uber now. All right, maybe I'm the villain in that scenario, you know? Fuck you and your dead mate. Nah, all good. I'm sure his daughter's a lovely author. Anyway, see, that's my problem. I'm like, I've really stepped in it by ridiculing a man's dead friend. And then I'm going, yeah, but also fuck his kids. No, I'm not Prince Andrew. Anyway, all right, let's move on here. What else has been happening? Jeez, it's been a pretty stressful week for the fans of Australian women's soccer. All five of you. It's been a very stressful week. For women everywhere, because the captain of the Australian women's soccer team, Sam Kerr, who has been just an icon for women, and a well-deserved, right? She's a fucking champion. Well, not a champion, but you know what I mean? She gave it a good shot. And she's been hailed as a feminist icon. She's right at the front of the pack. She's really revitalized. Really, Sam Kerr and her team is the reason why there's been this giant, massive swell of support for women's sport in Australia from women, right? Because before it was like kind of like, oh, really trying to make it happen. But finally, I feel like it's kicked on. And it's not just because of the Australian women's soccer team, but I feel like they were really the catalyst that really ensured that all the groundwork that all the men were laying has started to kick off. And now women's sport in Australia has really blown up and is in the mainstream conversation. But after the World Cup, they kind of disappeared from the conversation and there was a little bit of worry of like, oh, well, when they come back, are people going to care about this sport or women's sport in general if they don't have a legendary run, you know? But finally, Sam Kerr has been thrust back into public consciousness because a headline dropped saying that she's been accused of racially abusing a taxi driver in the UK. Now, that now, what's more Australian sport than that? They say that women's sport doesn't compare to men's sport. Well, I say they're obviously on the same playing field. Clearly, all right? Because is there anything more Australian sporting legend than abusing a taxi driver at night? Racially. Couldn't think of it. That's almost a rite of passage. Every single sports star needs to have a blow up in a taxi. I mean, fuck, just about every single big media star needs to have some kind of blow up with a taxi. If you haven't punched a taxi driver in the face, you're not an Australian celebrity. Karl Stefanovic, great example. He was in the back of a cab. Who was he talking shit about? His brother? I think he's talking shit about his brother, and the taxi driver recorded it and sold it to the news. You're not famous in this country until you have the teeth of a taxi driver in your pocket. And that's the real shame about Uber blowing up in popularity, is that it's definitely cost us a lot of Australian celebrities. Think about how much more famous I would be if I king hit a taxi driver. That's what's really holding me back. You know, a taxi driver almost fucking killed me. We're going to go on a big detour here. I had to travel for something which you will be illuminated about in the coming months, but I can't say anything. But I'm coming back from the airport, and I was given a cab charge by someone, who knows. And I fucking hate cab charges. Not because I like paying for my transport. A cab charge, if you don't know, you give it to the, instead of paying for it, it charges the company, whoever they may be, or person, right? And I've got a cab charge, and I fucking hate cab charges, not because I like paying for my transport, but because it means that I have to take a taxi. Have you ever almost died in an Uber?
No.
Me neither. Never almost died in an Uber. Have you almost died in a taxi?
Yeah.
I have, several times, on the one trip, and it was the last trip that I took. I'm going back from the airport, right? And I have a cab charge. And normally, because I'm in Frankston, right? A taxi from Frankston to the airport is like $200. So generally, I'll stay at my parents', which is way closer. But if I really, really, really have no other option, I'll pre-book an Uber. And whoever picks me up is like ready to cry. They're just like, I can't believe it. I get to go all the way from Frankston to the airport. I'm going to make $200 there, and then I'm probably going to get at least a $100 fee back. This is fucking awesome. And same in the reverse. If I'm going from the airport back home, rarely when I've done it, the Ubers are always like, let's fucking go. This is my lucky day. I love you, brother. I'm not going to talk to you at all. And I go, thanks so much. 5 stars. I'm at the airport and I'm going to the taxi rank and I'm shitty already. I gotta get a fucking taxi. And I walk up to this taxi and this ancient man gets out. Like he was so fucking old that I don't think he should have been allowed to be walking on his feet, let alone driving a fucking taxi. You ever see a taxi driver get out of a car, you see how they walk, and you're like, oh, he can't drive. Like, not that he's a bad driver, I'm saying, like, physically, the man can't drive. That's what I was dealing with. I've got 2 suitcases with me. He opens up the boot, and fair enough, whatever, I can put it in the boot myself. If he was a pretty old guy, I'll do it myself. All good. Uber driver would have done it for me, but whatever. No worries. And then I go Frankston, and his eyes light up. And then I go, I've got a cab charge. Is that all right? And he laughs at me. Like, oh, fuck this guy. Like one of those laughs. Like, oh, yeah, all right. Which was just him going, oh, so I can't rob this guy. Because that's the thing about the cab charge, right? When you're just paying without a cab charge, it's all good. They can do whatever the fuck they want to you. They can start it at $30 and you're fucked. And that's happened to me heaps. But with the cab charge, because it's such a big company, because when he was so fucking rude about it, in the back of the taxi, I'm Googling, why the fuck is he pissed off about my cab charge? They have to start the meter at zero with the cab charge, or the cab charge will be like, you're paying for it. We see that you fucked us. We're not paying for it. That's on you. Free fare. So he was pissed off because he couldn't fucking rob me. Straight away. Shit experience. I get in the car with this dude. I'm in the back. And within 10 minutes, there's a car behind us going, and he's fucking swerving. I'm holding on to like the wall. I'm like, oh my God, what the fuck? And then 10 minutes after that, it happens again. The guy's in the wrong fucking lane. Three cars are holding down their horn. I'm going, oh my God. I'm like about to ask him if I can get out. And then I'm like, oh no, but that would be awkward. How many people have fucking died in cars because they're like, oh yeah, he's pretty drunk, but I don't want to be rude. I would wager 25% of deaths could have been prevented by, can you pull over here, mate? I need to take a wee. And then you get out and you go, open the boot, give me my fucking shit. See ya. I should have done that. You know when they're swerving and you just start, like you're on the fucking freeway and it's like, he was doing those ones heaps. And then he was also doing like fucking 20 kilometers over the speed limit. Like, it was fucking scary. Terrible driver. Man almost killed me. But the worst one was, we get like, we're almost there. We're about 20 minutes away. It's a really long trip. About 20 minutes away. And he goes, oh, I just need to stop the car and wee. I'm like, yeah, totally fine. I don't care. Thinking that he would get off the fucking freeway and no. He stops like in front of a fucking exit. Like there's no emergency lane there. It's right before the fucking exit. And he just gets out of the car. And dude, I'm just like, oh my God. I go to get out of the car. The fucking back thing's locked. I can't figure out how to unlock it. It was like a child lock or something. And he's just left me in this car right in front of the fucking exit. Every car that drives past, like, meh, meh. I'm thinking, oh, holy shit. This is how I die. Because this guy was upset at me for using a cab charge. He got back in and dude, I've never done this in my life, lodged a complaint. I took down his number and I was like, he's actually going to kill himself. You know, this dude should not be fucking driving. I've never done that shit in my life. I was like, oh, I don't want to fucking complain. But I'm like, dude, this guy almost killed me four times in a row and then left me right in front of an exit while cars are going like 80 kilometers down. It was right in front of a corner too. So cars were like turning around the corner and then seeing his car there. Real dangerous. So, anyway, Sam Kerr, who's now my favorite female sports star, is in the news for racially abusing a taxi driver. Who said women can't do things the boys do? All right, that's a real sports team captain from Australia. Racially abusing a taxi driver, let's go. But that's all that was said. There was no context. All that was said was that there was a complaint lodged by the taxi driver that Sam Kerr had racially abused him. Let me pull up the headline here. Let's have a look. All right. Sam Kerr is accused of racially harassing... Oh, sorry, a police officer. Where did I get taxi driver from?
I also thought it was a taxi driver.
Right. See what we've done here is we've actually done the really racist thing where all we read was UK racial abuse and then we filled in the gaps and were like, oh, if she was being racist, it must have been a taxi driver. I would like to formally apologize to Sam Kerr.
No, you're right. It's... what Sam Kerr allegedly said to UK cop after taxi fare dispute.
Oh, okay. Thank God. Well, you apology rescinded, you racist.
After all right. Throwing up in a taxi.
She threw up in a taxi? That's my captain. That is my captain. Getting into a fight with a taxi driver after spewing in their car and then racially abusing a police officer. That's my captain. Let's go, Sam Kerr. That's the type of representation that Australia needs. You know, we had Shane Warne. He's gone now. Rest his soul. Sam Kerr is stepping up to the plate. All right. So, that was the headline. Sam Kerr is accused of racially harassing a police officer in the UK. And then, that was a few days ago. Then just today, 6 hours ago, everyone has been waiting with bated breath to find out what Sam Kerr has said. Because this is the thing. If she's racially abused someone, her audience will not stand for that. She'll lose her captaincy. She'll lose her endorsements. She will lose everything. There is nothing that I could imagine Sam Kerr saying in terms of racial abuse that I could think the people would let her get away with. Until I read what she actually said. And I realized she's going to be just fine. She called the police officer who accused her of racially abusing her. She called him a stupid white bastard. Let's go! She said white. It's fine. No worries. All good. Encouraged even. Celebrated. Everyone loves it. That's right. And dude, the comments are just so funny. Everyone's like, oh, what a relief. Oh, thank goodness she was abusing a white guy. I thought she was throwing out slurs to someone of Asian descent. That'd be wrong. But she's abusing a white copper, so it's all good. Isn't it funny I just find that whole thing funny. I don't give a fuck. I think those laws are silly. You know, I don't think, I guess if it's a police officer, it's a little bit different. But like, I don't know, the UK is a very sensitive place when it comes to all of those fucking laws. They don't have freedom of speech at all. Like you can say some shit on Twitter that isn't racist, that isn't sexist. That's just like a mean dunk on someone and you can have police show up to your door for cyberbullying. It's like a fucking weird place. But I just love how every one of these people that are celebrating now were just frothing at the bit, ready to fucking take everything she had. And then we're like, ah, white. That's all right. All good. Been there, done that. Really good stuff. The alleged comments made by Matilda's captain, Sam Kerr, according to The Sun, Kerr was charged with a racially aggravated offense. A stupid white bastard. Is that racist? It depends. It depends on the intonation of the white, I would say. You stupid white bastard. That's racist. Are you stupid white bastard? That's not racist. Especially if he was standing next to an Asian fellow and a black guy. That can be just descriptive. You know? I feel like it depends entirely on the intonation. You stupid... How about this? What sounds more racist? Stupid white bastard? Stupid black bastard? Ooh, that's bad. Stupid Asian bastard? That's all right. I don't mind that. For some reason, that doesn't hit as hard. It's definitely worse than stupid white bastard. But, geez, stupid black bastard sounds bad. I wouldn't say that, Sam Kerr. The top comment is... All of her sponsorships breathe a sigh of relief. Yeah, she's not going to lose fucking anything. It's so funny. I don't know. What a fragile police officer, hey? What a little fucking baby. Some girl, you stupid white bastard. I'm lodging a complaint. What does he get out of that? I don't know. I just think it's... I just love how ready everyone is... How ready everyone was to fucking cancel her and ruin her. And it was like, oh, white? Oh, no worries. All good. I'm just glad that it got in the news at all because that really is what Australian women's sports needs. Is one of our star female players throwing up in a taxi and then racially abusing a police officer. That's Australian sport, you know? That makes me want to sing the national anthem, or at least the first verse of which the words I remember half of. What do we have here? Oh, that's right. This episode is brought to you by the spring cleaning champions, Manscaped. We've got a sponsor. Let's go. All right. Welcome, Manscaped, to the game. This is really good because I used Manscaped products all the time when they sponsored the show. But ever since they stopped sponsoring, I've been growing the gnarliest bush of all time. Finally, I've gotten to trim it thanks to the 2024... oh, we don't read that bit. intro. This episode is brought to you by the spring cleaning champions, Manscaped TM. This season, make sure to groom your carpets and the drapes. Oh, that was all caps, that end. Make sure to groom your carpets and the drapes with the leaders in below-the-waist grooming. Clear out that winter bush with Manscaped TM's Lawnmower 5.0. Jeez, this lawnmower technology keeps innovating over and over again. What's it got on it this time? A fucking heat-seeking missiles that take pubes out like nothing else? Lawnmower 5.0, and watch your confidence bloom like the springtime flowers. Embrace the season and join the 10 million men worldwide who trust Manscaped with our special offer. Go to manscaped.com and use code CODE. What's our code? Use code SPEARS for 20% off and free shipping. For the love of God, if you want me to keep the ad reads funny, the deal is you've got to buy it and use the code SPEARS. Use code SPEARS for 20% off and free shipping. That's the deal. They don't like the funny ad reads if they don't convert. So that's the fucking deal. You want these to be funny, you got to use code SPEARS for 20% off and free shipping. Without the script, fucking brilliant product. Okay, I've been using the previous generation. It's really good. This one's even fucking better. All right? Do not read. Host to talk about a funny grooming story down there or life before Manscaped. Oh, dude, life before Manscaped? Actually, for real, even if they weren't paying me, horrible. Remember those? Did you? I used a razor, got rid of all of it. And let me tell you, the first 4 hours of that is immaculate. You're feeling great. Oh, I look good, nice and smooth. 4 hours and 30 minutes, you're like, this is the worst thing I've ever done in my fucking life. And then the next day, it's like you've just put a couple of lychees down your pants. You're just prickly and chafing and rashy and it's fucked. Don't ever do that. All right? You want to trim it. I like the Manscaped one because they have multiple different lengths. You can trim it. You can give yourself a fade down there if you wanted to. I don't know if you would want to, but if you did, you could.
I have a little story, a funny little story.
Yeah, a funny little story about your funny little fella.
When I was a teenager, I was...
What's the code?
Spears.
And what do you get?
20% off and free shipping.
Wow. Anyway, tell your story.
And so I was shaving down there.
Yeah. And How old are you?
About 16, 17.
Yeah.
It was for a lady friend. And then I cut myself. And to this very day, I have a scar on... my penis.
Show me. Oh, yeah. Yum. Use code SPEARS for 20% off and free shipping. You have a, where's the scar?
It's on like the side, like the base side.
Of your dick?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It's still there. But I never had that problem with Manscaped.
No, absolutely not. And you never will. As long as you use code SPEARS for 20% off and free shipping. Get 20% off and free shipping with code SPEARS at manscaped.com. That's 20% off and free shipping with the code SPEARS at manscaped.com. Nothing like a little spring cleaning in your pants. Thank you very much to Manscaped for sponsoring the show. Seriously, if you want a groomer, grab one of these, use the code because it supports the show and it's honestly a genuinely good product. And if we want to maintain our loose leash on these, we have to actually grab them. So do that. Thank you. All right. What else? Oh, dude, Virgin are finally letting pets on planes. I'm stoked about this. I'm so excited. Well, I was so excited about this until they said small pets in cages. Apparently, I can't bring my 42-kilo... American Staffy Great Dane pit bull looking animal beast on the plane. Apparently not. Even though I know for sure, without a shadow of a doubt, she would be better behaved than half the fucking humans on that plane, let alone the animals. It's no good. But I am still stoked about it because that would make flights so much better for me just to look over and see a cat having a panic attack. or just like a little doggy give him a scratch through the bars. That's nice. I think that's good. They've been doing it in America for years and years and years. Even if you have a big animal, you can just buy him a seat. I don't think there's anything wrong with it. You know, the fucking top comment on the news about this was, what about people with allergies? What's going to happen to them? I don't know. What happens to you fucks everywhere? Deal with it. You got allergies? Wear a face mask. Take an antihistamine. If you're deathly allergic to dogs, don't go outside. Well, you lost. You lost that one. My brother, if he eats one peanut, will fucking die. He's not going on a plane being like, actually, no one's allowed to have peanuts. Just don't eat one. Well, but their hair gets everywhere. Okay, sorry. Too bad. If I got to deal with a fucking baby screaming in hysterics while their mother does nothing but try and shove an iPad in its fucking face. You can deal with a dog in a cage, all right? You'll be all right. I've got a runny nose. Wear a face mask. The solution is there. If you're that fucking scared about getting an animal hair in your nose, that's annoying. Maybe they should be able to tell the airline, I don't want to sit in the same row as a dog. And cool, fair enough. But then you know what? Fucking everyone's going to do that. I'm allergic to dogs. I don't want to be near a dog. I think it's good. You know what is going to be fucking, say like a flight to Perth, all those animals are going to be shitting and pissing. That's the only thing. 4-hour flight. My dog could hold it. My dog, we put her in a cage on the Spirit of Tasmania. That's overnight. She didn't piss or shit once. I don't know how she did it. We fed her beforehand, not heaps. We gave her some water. But she's like, I'm not pooing. But yeah, I think that's awesome. Although it's just annoying now. I can't take my dog. Now it's like everyone except for your dog can go. Because she would love the plane. My dog loves the car. She puts her fucking head on the center console. She sits in the back and puts her head on the center console. I put my elbow on her head. She loves it. In the few times we've had to take an Uber pet, she'll even do it. I'll sit in the back with her and she will refuse to sit any other way except for her head on the center console. And every now and then you'll have like a Muslim guy or an Indian guy that just never grew up with animals, that they don't even know that they've said yes to Uber pet, and they'll be driving and then my dog will put its giant fucking head in the center console, brush their elbow, and they'll go, ah! Friendly brother? She friendly? I'm like, yeah, she's friendly. Oh, okay. And I have to grab her and pull her away, put her on my lap. She's like, but I want to see where we're going. That would be the problem if I took her on the plane. She would insist on being on the pilot's lap. Which would be a problem because her full name is Muhammad. Anyway, I've fallen massively, massively behind on my 100 swims goal for this year because I had something come up that I can't talk about and I just completely fell behind. Not fucked forever behind, but like I need to do like five, I need to do like 10 swims, I think, to catch up to what I've missed. I think that's the goal. Because when I was in Perth, I thought I was going to swim a lot more than I did. But I just didn't have the time. That's a lie. I couldn't be fucked going all the way to the pool. I was too far away from it. On maps, it looked close, and I was just too far away. Yeah. So next time, I think instead of staying close to the venue, I'm going to stay close to the pool. That's going to be my thing. But I need to catch up. So me and Keelan have agreed that twice a day for the next couple of weeks, we're going to go swimming. That's not true, but I am going to go heaps. I'm going to try and go like multiple times a week until I catch back up because I really want to do my 100 swims. How are you going for your swims?
I think I'm up to 18.
So are you on track or you're behind as well?
I'm a little bit behind because when I went to the Gold Coast, I just...
It's hard when you're traveling.
I was in a great routine of going pool and gym and then I fell out of it.
Mm. Yeah, yeah. But
I've been going a few times this week. I think tomorrow morning I'll go early.
Yeah.
It'll be fourth for the week.
Okay, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to go. I'm getting back into it now. It also, fuck, too hot.
I go at 7 in the morning.
I need to do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, if I don't go, because that's the thing. I was like, because I can go to gym at like fucking midnight. I've been loving doing that. Go to gym really late. It's not too hot. Because it's too fucking hot to work out at the gym because it's upstairs when it's really hot in the middle of the day. So I've been going at nighttime, but all the pools are closed at night.
Yeah.
Why can't we have some midnight pools? Are they even legal in this country? Probably not, or I assume that they're not because I've never seen one anywhere that's open after like 9.
If you go to like hotels, it's always like pool closes at 9, but the doors are never locked.
Yeah. Yeah, that really is like, we're not liable for you drowning after 9.
Yeah. Swim at your own risk.
Yeah. See, that's what I want. That is what I want. You know, I guess it's like, you can't have pools open at fucking 11, 12 at midnight in this country because it's just going to be like, bro, let's fucking go for a swim, bro. And then you drown. You can't have that. What I really need is to, 8 months ago, invest all of the money that I don't have into Bitcoin. Oh. Have you seen it's rocketing now?
No.
Over $100,000 for a Bitcoin now.
And we've been talking for months.
Didn't I tell you? I was like, if I had money, this is all me and Killen have been saying, dude, I'm telling you, in the next fucking 8 months, it's going to rocket up and explode. And me and Killen have been like, I feel like I've just been watching someone else fuck my wife. Being like, I could have done that.
We've both been saying it all of last year.
Yeah.
If only we had money.
Yeah. Shouldn't have bought this bloody house. I could have had a Bitcoin. You know, grass is always greener. But yeah, fuck. I think it's going to continue. Don't put any money into it. All right. Don't. You're not smart enough. There's only two types of people in this market. Lucky cunts and dumb cunts. And the lucky ones aren't smart, if you know what I mean. But I think it's just going to rocket up fucking all year and I'm just going to have to watch and be like, I love to pay my mortgage. All right, guys, we're going to end the episode there. A nice little short one. But next week's going to be a bit longer. We're going to continue on Patreon right now. If you want access to the Patreon exclusive episodes, help support the show and the Discord, as well as a bunch of other rewards, check out patreon.com/loosebeers. But even more important than that, I would say, at least for the next two episodes, manscaped.com, use code SPEARS for 20% off and free shipping. The lawnmower 5.0. Dude. Technology is getting good. Pretty, do you reckon the 6.0 is going to have AI in it?
Possibly.
Rogue pube detected. You don't even have to turn it on. It just shoots a laser from your bathroom into your ball bag and it just comes off immediately.
The 5.0 has a face shaver thing so you can go from shaving your balls to shaving your face.
Oh, that's good. That's actually what the last one needed. Mate, I'm sold. Use code SPEARS, 20% off, free shipping. And I'll talk to you right now on Patreon. Have a shit one. Bye.